Out of the 1.4 million people living with HIV/AIDS in the country, 75% of these are said to be young people. Unfortunately, these young people range from 15 to 21 years, and they're mostly young women. Gloria Nawanyanga, an HIV advocate who has lived with HIV for the past 26 years, has called for more sensitization of the young people in the fight against HIV and AIDS.
If young people are educated, trust me, we'll end AIDS by 2030. Number two, empowerment. There's so many young people who are getting HIV because they're not empowered. They don't know what to do. They don't know what their role is. But I believe in the National HIV Symposium, everyone is going to be empowered with knowledge, with the skills, but also informing yourself that, I mean, you have a role to play.
The most vulnerable girl we have in the country is the girl out of school and unemployed. So one of our key programs for the adolescent girl and young woman is to keep girls in school. And the government has done so much. But even when they are put universal secondary education, universal primary education, a significant number still get out of school because of various reasons. And those reasons vary from girl to girl. So our adolescent girls and young program is really focused on an individual. We deal with an individual. Are you out of school? Can you get back to school? Perfect. Are you married? Because some of the adolescent girls were married off when they were still very young. So what is your risk? Is your risk as an individual, how can we minimize it?
This is still very important for the young child. You shouldn't involve yourself with sex activities, but we know that there are young emancipated girls. Oh, you're in S1, you're 13 years, you get a boyfriend of 15, you get a baby. All of you, the three, you are victims, but you're all young people. So we as parents, that's why we said it's almost each and everyone's responsibility to actually help these young people, to guide and tell them it's not right to hush into sexual activities, because the challenges when you hurry there are more than when you're still in school or you're free from sex.
Globally, Uganda is ranked 5th of the countries with the highest HIV burden. Uganda AIDS Commission data reveals that in 2022, the country registered a total of 52,000 new HIV infections, which is unacceptably high. The same report indicates that out of 20,000 HIV infections that occurred among young people in 2022, about 15,000 new HIV infections were among adolescent girls, and the remaining 5,000 occurred among adolescent boys. This implies that HIV infections are 3 times higher among adolescent girls and young women aged between 15 to 24 years than among males of the same age. The head of HIV prevention at the Uganda AIDS Commission, Dr. Daniel Byamukama, has called for more funding of the Uganda AIDS Commission from government.
We look forward, as part of financing dialogue, to report the detail of the amount of financing we need to deliver on the promise of ending the AIDS pandemic. Without adequate financing, we shall not be able to deliver our promise, which is within reach.
Uganda AIDS Commission is also organizing the National HIV and AIDS Scientific Symposium, which will take place at Kololo Ceremonial Grounds next month. This symposium, whose theme is, "It's My Responsibility Towards Ending HIV and AIDS by 2030, will feature a series of activities including the annual Joint AIDS Review, Scientific Conference, the Philly Lutaya Lecture, and the HIV Financing Dialogue. Report compiled by Jaliet Namawaya for the news.